आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर वानी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन जुआलॉजी, डॉक्टर वी एस कृष्णा, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज, विशाखापट्टनम. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ बैक क्रॉस एंड अ टेस्ट क्रॉस. टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस, लेट अस फर्स्ट रिकलेक्ट अ सिंपल मेंडेलियन मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस. इन दिस एग्जाम्पल वी हैव टेकन a pure tall plant and crossed it with a pure dwarf plant. These two plants are called as parental generation or P generation. The gametes obtained from a pure tall plant are capital T, whereas the gametes obtained from pure dwarf plant is small t. A cross between these two plants lead to an offspring which are all heterozygous in nature, that is capital T, small t. Now, these plants are called as heterozygous tall plants. Now, these plants are termed as F generation plants. Now, let us understand what a back cross is. A back cross is a cross of a F1 hybrid with any one of its parents, that is either a homozygous dominant parent or a homozygous recessive parent. Now, the back cross is used in horticulture, animal breeding, and in the production of gene knockout organisms. Now let us understand what a back cross is from this simple cross. Here we can say that a tall plant is crossed with a dwarf plant. The P generation plants are pure in nature, that is homozygous in nature. The F1 hybrids obtained are all heterozygous in nature, that is heterozygous tall plants. Now, a back cross is a cross with this hybrid F1 plants with either of its parents, that is either with the dominant tall homozygous parent or a dwarf homozygous parent. In the first case, we can see that when a hybrid tall plant is crossed with its dominant tall parent, all the offsprings obtained are tall in nature. In the second cross, we see that when a hybrid F1 tall plant is crossed with a homozygous recessive dwarf parent, then the offsprings obtained are tall is to dwarf in the ratio 1 is to 1. Now, why is this difference? In the first case, we see that the hybrid plant produces two types of gametes, that is capital T and small t, whereas a homozygous tall parent produces single type of gametes, that is capital T. Now, when a heterozygous tall is crossed with a homozygous tall, we get all tall plants which are phenotypically tall, but when we look into the genotype, we get two types of genotype, that is homozygous tall plant and heterozygous tall plant. But in terms of phenotype, all plants are tall. In the second case, when we cross a hybrid tall plant with a dwarf plant, we see that the tall plant produces two types of gametes, capital T and a small t, whereas a dwarf parent produces only one type of gamete, that is small t. In such a cross, we find that the offsprings obtained are heterozygous tall, that is capital T small t, and a dwarf plant, that is small t small t. Now this second example, where a F1 hybrid is crossed with a homozygous recessive parent, this second type of back cross is also known as a test cross. Now let us understand why this test cross is so important in genetics. Now what is a test cross? For this, now let us look at this picture. Here we can see two tall plants and a dwarf plant. So phenotypically these two are tall and the third one is a dwarf plant. If we want to know the genotype, the dwarf plant being recessive in nature, its genotype is small t. But if we want to know the genotype of a tall plant, it can be of two types. It can be either a homozygous tall plant, that is capital T, or a heterozygous tall plant, that is capital T and small t. In a cross, if we want to know the genotype of a tall plant, that is whether it is a homozygous tall or a heterozygous tall, we need to do a test cross to identify whether the tall is homozygous in nature or a heterozygous in nature. So, what is a test cross? A test cross is a cross between an organism with a dominant phenotype but whose genotype is unknown and an organism that is homozygous recessive phenotype. The one which we have seen in the back cross, the second type of back cross. Now, a test cross is used to determine whether the individual in question is heterozygous in nature or homozygous in nature. Now, let us understand what a test cross is from this simple cross. So, the first cross, we have seen a normal monohybrid cross where a pure tall plant is crossed with a pure dwarf plant and where all the offsprings obtained are tall in nature but they are heterozygous in nature, that is they are hybrids. Now if we want to know whether these tall plants are homozygous tall or heterozygous tall, we need to cross these tall plants with a recessive parent, that is with a dwarf plant. So let us have look into these two different types of cross. In the first cross, we have crossed a tall plant with a recessive dwarf plant. In this case, we have seen that all the obtained offsprings are tall in nature. In the second type of a cross, when we have crossed a tall plant again with a dwarf plant, here the offsprings obtained are in the ratio of tall is to dwarf, that is 1:1 ratio. Now why is it so? In the first case, the tall plant is homozygous tall, but in the second case, it is heterozygous tall. So let me explain the first type, that is the homozygous tall. Now in the case of a homozygous tall plant, the gametes obtained from such a tall plant are all capital T in nature. Whereas the gametes obtained from the dwarf plant are small t in nature. Now in such a cross, capital T small t leads to a combination of capital T small t, that is heterozygous tall plants. So here all the plants are tall phenotypically and genotypically they are heterozygous in nature, capital T small t. So when a tall plant is homozygous in nature and such a tall plant is crossed with a dwarf plant, all the offsprings obtained will be tall plants. Now let us take the example where a tall plant is heterozygous in nature. If a tall plant is heterozygous in nature, it produces two types of gametes, capital T and small t. When such a plant is crossed with a dwarf plant, the dwarf plant produces only one type of gamete, that is small t. So, in such a cross, we get two types of combinations, capital T, small t, as well as small t and small t. So, in such a case, the obtained offsprings will be tall is to dwarf, that is 1:1 ratio. Hence, if a tall plant is heterozygous in nature and if a test cross is done to such a plant, the obtained offsprings will be having a ratio of tall is to dwarf in 1:1 ratio. If a tall plant is homozygous in nature and it is undergoing a test cross, then all the offsprings will be only tall phenotypically. So, hence from this we understand that a test cross is done to determine the genotype of a dominant character, whether it is homozygous dominant or a heterozygous dominant, by looking at its offsprings. So, friends, so that is the difference between a test cross and a batch cross. So, dear students, let us summarize what we have learned till now. In a batch cross, when F1 hybrid is crossed to a homozygous dominant parent, all the progeny will be dominant in phenotype. Whereas, when the F1 hybrid is crossed to a homozygous recessive parent, 50% of the progeny will be dominant and 50% of the progeny will be recessive. This is same as a test cross. Now let us summarize about test cross. In a test cross, when a dominant phenotype is homozygous in nature, all the progeny will be dominant in phenotype. Whereas, when the dominant phenotype in question is heterozygous in nature, 50% of the progeny will be dominant and 50% will be recessive. Thus, test cross ratio for a monohybrid cross involving heterozygous individual is 1:1. Now, students, here ends our video lesson. Now, let me see if you can answer some of the questions based on this video. Test your knowledge by answering these following 5 questions. And for the answers, you can click the next slide. So, students, here are the answers for the questions. Thank you.